tonight on the podcast, we have...
I'm going to save it till the end.
Oh, all right. Trevor?
Maybe a little bit later.
Okay. One more. Okay. Jamie, you got anything?
I'm not feeling it right now. Maybe later.
Okay, I guess we're saving it all for the end. On the official Team D.B.A.H. podcast, number 178. Come join us, why don't you? Hello, and welcome back. It is the official Team D.B.A.H. podcast, number 178. I am your host tonight, the MC, I'm your captain now, still, I guess, maybe. I am Craig, and I have a very motley crew here tonight. Tonight we have James. James,
hey, what's up?
Good. We have Trevor, if he is awake.
I am awake.
There he is. How are you, Trevor?
Good, Craig. How are you?
Good. And a man that is loaded with tea so he can be on the podcast, none other than Jamie himself.
Hello.
How are you?
I am well, good sir.
Good. What time is it there?
It is 1:30 in the morning.
Perfect.
That's not too terrible.
There, Gala. As the podcast goes on.
1:30, terrible.
And there is the man behind the curtain, Randall.
Yay.
Who's always listening. Always. Even when the computer's off.
Always watching.
So, everyone's good? Everyone's awake?
Feeling Seems it? Like it.
Good. How's, have you modded anything this week, James?
No, unfortunately I have not modded anything yet. I did finish filming my review of the Falcon Fire, though, and nice. I actually do have to get started because I need to get my hotshot completed before next week's episode of Back to Basics. So, there's that.
Nice. How's the, did you put anything else up new on your gaming channel?
No, I've had some editing issues where every time I almost get done with a save file, it, for some reason, Lightworks just likes to crash on me and I have to start all over again.
Oh.
But unfortunately, at that point, I'm very heartbroken and I'm like, God damn it. And I just put it aside and I just don't get to it.
I had the same issue with the Roxio editor when I started. Every time I'd go to edit, I'd save it. I'd go to export it, it would crash, I would go back and it'd be like, hey, it's corrupted since it crashed during export. And I was like, why?
Hooray, yeah, technology.
Yeah, it gets to like maybe about halfway exported, and then all of a sudden it just disappears. Doesn't even say like, you know, has encountered a problem or needs to close or whatever. No, it's just fucking gone. And I'm like, oh, yay.
Yeah, that's a YouTuber. Yeah. Have you tried? I knew Charlie does it. He edits a lot on YouTube. I personally could not get the hang of it. I hate it a lot.
Me too.
Very much so.
Yeah, I've never used the YouTube editor myself. It's either I go very, very old school and just use Windows Media Movie Maker, or like with the Team Dad Joke stuff, I just use Lightworks because it's a. I can do the multicam bins and all that stuff with it. So. Mm.
Yeah, he's pretty good at it. I just can't. It hurts me sometimes.
Yeah.
It just hurts. Trevor, we haven't heard from you in a while. So what have you been up to? What have you been playing? What are you doing?
I would actually answer this question,
mm-hmm,
but I'm
mm-hmm.
going to delay it until later on because I want to bring it up later.
All right.
Nothing shady about that.
Nothing at all, especially that laugh.
I don't want to derail the topic that much now.
Oh my goodness. All right. So, James.
It sounds like he's in court. He's just like, I don't really want to talk about me.
Plead the fifth,
Your Honor.
It's just...
I plead the fifth.
Let's talk about you.
Let's talk about you, Judge. Is that your real hair?
No. Well then, Jamie, how are you? What have you been playing? What are you doing? Anything?
I'm gonna have to wait until later.
Damn it!
Okay, I'm good now.
Well, we could just pull up a list of He-Man characters and just start going
we
off
could,
of that again.
I mean, we could do that. We could do that.
I mean, this guy's got 8 arms. I mean,
Arm-tor.
Yeah. Well,
Arm-tor, yeah.
Well, I know something that would make you happy if you've ever played other Blizzard games. Well, actually, that's the correction. Have you ever played Warcraft?
World of Warcraft, yeah.
Yeah, so, if you know, Blizzard is changing something about Warcraft monies.
All right.
So, not too long ago, Blizzard let you use in-game gold to buy game time. So you can use in-game gold, you can pay for the next, you know, month that you play.
Yeah.
But now, they've done something pretty cool. If you have a lot of gold sitting in your Warcraft account and you don't really play anymore, you can actually purchase in-game items in Overwatch and Heroes of the Storm.
What? So you're telling me I have to play Warcraft now?
Well, you don't have to.
Well, I mean, more gold equals more stuff in Overwatch, right?
Yes.
Yes. So my hearing,
I have to.
So what I'm hearing is Team D.B.A.H. needs to play WoW together.
Hey man, we could do a whole series on that. That could just be a.
You hear that, Charlie?
Oh, don't say serious.
Oh no!
It's official. God. The Team D.B.A.H. WoW cast.
Hey, why not? I mean, people watch it. People watch
we'll be
it.
We could all be pandas.
Yeah. Now, well,
I want to be a Death Knight panda.
Well,
I don't know if that's a thing, but I want to do it.
I don't think you can be. Yeah, no. I don't think so. I mean, that would be
cool. I think they can be anything. I thought they could.
You're gonna make
they have no allegiance.
Damn it.
They are a very neutral race.
Yes.
They are. Well, because you once you go through their intro story, you have to pick what side you want to be on.
The only problem with Death Knight Panda would be that you have to get enough accounts levels like 65 before you unlock Death Knight.
Yeah.
Like, don't worry, this isn't my main character, I'm just waiting till I can be a Death Knight Panda. Running through every mission, like, destroying all the stories.
Yeah, no, officially, pandas cannot be Death Knights.
Alright, that's it, I'm out.
What about goblins? Be a little goblin. Charge them the money.
You could be a goblin. Orcs can be that, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Orcs.
Orcs can be Death Knights.
Okay, maybe I might do it then.
Alright, well though, when you're a Death Knight, you have to... You actually start the game at level 55. So, in order to be a Death Knight, you have to have a level, like, 55 character to make a Death Knight.
Oh.
Not that character, to make a new character, which is a Death Knight.
Huh.
Though the armor is really cool.
Yeah.
I actually transmogged it so it stays the original Death Knight looking. Right. Yeah, because what happens in Warcraft with any MMO, when you start to collect, you know, gear, you kind of look like a hobo.
Yeah.
Because nothing, I think that's why they made transmogging, because you have like rainbow pants on, like a leather coat. Like, you have antlers on your head. It's horrible.
I did like that. I always remember liking that the clothes that I would wear, choose to wear, would change the appearance.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's one of my favorite things in any game is being able to customize the look of my character in such detail.
Yeah. Do you go crazy with it?
Yeah, I would. It's the kind of thing where you get a nice bit of armor, and it'd be better than your old armor, but if it didn't look right on the character, I'd just be like, no, I'm going to leave it.
Yeah.
It's like, I mean, there's a thing now where I'll just like there's certain games, like this Halo 5, is like I immediately got the armor that I wanted. And even though I've unlocked so much stuff since playing that, I'm always still stuck with the same armor class. So,
I remember to unlock that Dorito thing. Charlie and I ate a lot of Doritos to get some of those armor pieces. And then I never changed them because I just couldn't at that point.
Well, that's the thing. You get stuff. You just get to a point where you're just so happy with the way your character looks. Why would you want to change it? Yeah. I mean, I probably change my appearance in real life, you know, quite often. You know, I put a different t-shirt on, something like that. My character in GTA has probably looked the same for like 3 years.
Yeah, that's true.
Basically, me with 8 fish tattoos.
Speaking of GTA, does anyone still play GTA 5?
I dabble.
Dabble. Dabble online, or are you still just playing around?
Oh, I dabble online.
I'm online, and if I have nothing else to play, I'll just pull up a guide and try to do one of the, like, 6 collectible achievements.
Well, that's fair. That's fair. Because GTA is still selling strong after, what, has it been, what, 4 years, 5 years?
Yeah, something like that.
And well, it's still selling for, like, almost full price. Like, it hasn't dropped in price at all. Maybe, like, $10, but that's it.
The 360, you can get it cheap used, but, yeah, brand new, it's still, like, a full $60. Even on the 360.
Oh, really? Wow.
Yeah. At least last time I saw. I could be wrong. It could be down by now, but...
And a lot of people are buying the different card versions, too.
Yeah.
Because they want to start off with, you know, however $1 million.
Yeah.
That's just cheating.
They just want to buy rocket cars and ramp cars and all that crap.
Yeah. Jokes to them because they don't realize how fast that shit goes.
That's true. Well, since we're on GTA 5 and all, I guess I can make this announcement that this week's debauchery is actually going to be in GTA 5, so...
No kidding.
Yep, and Dave's going to be heading it up because apparently he's already made the DBAH Corporation, so... He's got...
I think I've seen him doing this.
He has... From what I was told last night, now, he did not give me details. He just says, oh, I have things in mind, and left it at that.
Oh, boy.
So, Friday night is going to be fun.
I mean, last time I was on a debauchery with GTA 5, like, we were all in Charlie's condo. and they were taking turns in the shower trying to sing.
I remember this. I remember everyone in the shower. That was when there was the shower glitch, and you could get multiple people in the shower at once.
Yes.
Oh, jeez.
That was what we were doing. I remember, back, and I remember early days GTA 5.
A video of that somewhere.
Yep.
I'm going to have to find that.
There's a lot. There's some great... I remember further back than that. I remember playing GTA 4 for debaucheries. And, like, GTA 4 multiplayer is one of those things that I think I only ever played a few times for debaucheries.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, there's such a difference between it and GTA 5.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
but it's kind of like everything's just based around the airport. That's where you can have the most fun.
And actually, you know, in our YouTube channel trailer, a GTA clip is a very key clip in that trailer.
With the bus rolling down the hill,
which I believe Randall was driving, possibly.
The bus is like skidding down here.
The bus.
Oh yeah, that was me.
Yeah, see, there you go.
Charlie's just repeating again and again. Oh no. Oh no.
Well, what actually led up to the bus flipping over? Like, were you guys going somewhere?
Up a mountain.
Yeah, I saw that. But wait, was there a reason you were...
Cops, I think.
Oh, okay.
It's the heist where you're, like, trying to just get the bus. So we just ran up the hill to get away from the cops. The bus is skidding all over the place. There's helicopters. Stuff like that. Charlie's going, oh no. And I remember about that later on.
Oh, yeah.
Later on, there's a part of the heist where there's a plane, and I'm driving the plane as the getaway pilot. I'm flying everyone to freedom. I'm doing flips, and Dave's like cursing at me. But Jamie, don't. You fuck this up. I'm like, I'm not going to fuck this up. Whoa.
The joy of multiplayer games. Actually, kind of related to that, sort of, did anyone get to try the Wildlands beta?
I was wanting to. I was disappointed I didn't.
I don't know what that is.
The Ghost Recon game.
Yeah. So it's Ghost Recon. It's by Ubisoft. It's a Ghost Recon Wildlands, where it's was built as a co-op game, or you can play solo and you have like three, you know, AI people with you. Yeah. So you go around to bust like a whole giant drug cartel.
Yep.
Constant drop in, drop out co-op.
Oh, yes. Okay.
Yep. Yeah.
Full customization anytime.
Which I've seen that. I've seen the customization options. They're pretty sweet.
Yep.
My problem with it is I'm looking at it a bit and I'm seeing a lot of division stuff.
Yeah, so what they've actually been working on this game for like 4 years. And I think this game is like, if you take Far Cry series and you take the Division. And you put them in a room together with some, you know, with some wine and some music.
Fancy Jesus.
They made a game, baby, called Wildlands. You know,
take a description.
And GTA is their crazy uncle.
And GTA is their crazy uncle.
That's pretty much what this game comes down to. I feel like this is the game they kind of wanted the Division to be.
Yeah, I can see that.
It also didn't help that their vision came out of what was going to be Rainbow Six Patriots.
I forgot about that game.
Yep.
I need a minute. You can talk about it. I need a minute to think about that.
Because, back a few years ago, Ubisoft was like, oh, hey, we're going to make another Rainbow Six game after the great success of both Vegas. And then they canceled it. To go into the Division, to make it into the Division and Siege.
Yeah. Does anyone play Siege?
I've played Siege.
I'm slowly getting back into it. But it's hard, because I wanted to play a Rainbow Six game, not CS:GO.
You don't want to play Counter-Strike, is what you're
saying. Yeah, I don't want to play tactical Counter-Strike.
Yeah,
it's very difficult to like level up in that game as well. Oh, experience is just barely anything. You could win a level, do really great, and it would just be like the bar moved like an inch.
Yeah, I feel like people in that, like, especially if you watch on Twitch, like people into Siege are really into it.
Yeah, it's a very like tactical.
There's
thing.
No like, there's no like middle ground. Either people it's the kind really of thing it, like game.
If you're playing a game and you pick their character, they'd probably message you saying how you've ruined their life, and then they'll just leave. It's a really intense thing. Like, everyone has their strategies. No one's like looking for fun. No one's looking for the interest.
Yeah.
It's literally like, it's almost like a chore to people. It's like they're actually in the war zone doing that stuff. It's like another day on the job. Like, you're playing a video game.
It's like those competitive Overwatch people.
Yeah. Whew. Oh god. I don't get how people play such a colourful, fun environment game like Overwatch and like take it just 100% serious. I mean, there's a gorilla and like an English girl who travels in time or whatever. It's not meant to be taken seriously.
Well, speaking of Overwatch, since we've come back to it, has anyone gotten any stuff for the Lunar New Year?
Not the achievements.
I have not. All my boxes have had like voiceovers in them. I'm like, eh. This is not what I wanted at all.
I got the Reinhardt and the Bastion.
I I mentioned last week, I had like so many credits. I think I got 25 loot boxes. Out of it, I think I got... why the fuck did I just blank on his name? I got Roadhog. I bought nice. Junkrat, because I didn't actually get him. I think I got Symmetra. I got D.Va. I got a ton of... I got a ton of voices. And I actually got, like, 4 Mace skins. I got the Firefighter. I got her Lunar New Year one. And I think I got, like, 2 of the rare ones as well. So it's kind of like, wow.
Oh.
It's too bad. Yeah, too bad I don't use her.
Now you're going to have to.
Yeah.
Just because.
I've only got the Bastion skin, but I'm okay with that still.
Oh, I think I did get Bastion, too. But yeah. So, yeah, it was 25 loot boxes, and I think I got 5 skins out of it. 6 if you count the one I bought from all the friggin' duplicates and gold and shit.
Nice. Yeah, I have really bad luck with, like, randomly, like, I got that Reaper skin, like, really early on when I got, when I started playing Overwatch. Which was a lovely gift from Charles. But ever since then, like, the skins I've gotten have been very, like, kind of bleh. I mean, I have the bug one for D.Va, which is kind of cool. And I recently did buy the Thunderbird skin for, what's her name?
Farrah.
Thank you. That looks pretty cool. I've actually never seen anyone actually use that, so. That's a cool looking skin. And also, because we talk about Overwatch all the time, Overwatch is getting its own server browser.
Really?
Mm-hmm. So I'm not sure if it's only going to be... I know it's in the, like, test... it's on their test servers. But I don't know if it's going to be just on PC or on PC and console.
Mm.
So that would be interesting. Yeah. It'd be interesting to rent a DBAH Overwatch server.
Keep from getting those lags and those drops and all of those disconnect messages. Oh, wait. I'm sorry. I'm thinking of Destiny. Never mind.
Oh, what's wrong with Destiny? Did it break again?
Nah, just every once in a while, there's always those frigging connection issues and all. It's like, we're working so fine. Then all of a sudden, oh, I got armadilloed. Wait, what?
Aww.
I don't know. It says I got armadilloed, and then you can't log in for like 20 minutes. Or you have to hard reset stuff.
I love that. When the game kicks you out, it's like, sucks. Oh, we're doing random repairs. See you in a bit. But,
yeah.
So, Trevor, do you want to tell us what you were playing?
I'll talk now.
Okay, sure. Go for it.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Because it's funny, because I can plug it at the same time at this point now.
Oh, boy.
So, tomorrow, there's a beta coming out for the public.
Oh?
Piranha's beta.
Oh, yeah?
Yep, so I was playing the closed beta all last weekend.
Mm-hmm.
But now that they're opening the beta, I think the open beta is going to be all of the characters now, I think. Instead of
is this going to be for everyone, or are you needing one of those codes?
It's an open beta. So you could actually pre-download the beta tonight or anytime prior to tomorrow, the 9th.
Oh, interesting. I remember I was in the alpha for that, for PC, and it was awful.
Yeah, I was in it for console. It wasn't bad. I think it's more of the whole mouse control thing. It's just bad.
Yeah, the controls on the keyboard were just not... it was just not good at all. It's good you don't need a key, because Ubisoft's system... Let's be honest. Usually their games are okay. Sometimes they're broken. Assassin's Creed. But their site, and I'm going to say it, it's horrible. It is god-awful. It randomly tells me my password, like my login's wrong when I know it's right, because it works on the phone, and it works on the app, but I go to, the website on a computer, it doesn't work. I go to send out codes, and the people I send the codes to don't get them. And then I talked to their support, and they're like, well, it said that the codes weren't sent. I'm like, okay, so how do I send them again? And then I talked to them, like, the same day, a couple hours later. And they're like, oh, this code's sent. I'm like, well, they didn't get the invite. Where did it go? Can you just give me the stupid code to give them, like everyone else does?
I like for their closed beta, I had the issue of, oh, okay, I sent codes out to people. Some of the codes I sent out were for the Xbox, some were sent out to the PC, because I apparently was invited to both.
Mm-hmm.
So just to quickly state, the open beta for Honor can be downloaded now on the Xbox.
Just to confirm,
you can download it now.
What Jamie's going to do right now...
TV's so bright.
Jamie's not going to sleep today.
Sleep is for the weak.
It is. Speaking of bright it's things, you. Did you guys...
It's the people in the normal time.
Did you guys see how big the high resolution pack for Fallout 4 is on Steam?
How big is it?
Take a guess.
12. Like
4 gigs?
What did you say?
4 gigs?
Nope. Guess again. Next
question. Jamie, would you like to go?
No.
All right, fine. I'll guess. Okay. I'll say 40.
You're getting closer. Though, as one thing, though, you do need at least a GTX 1080 card to run this and an i7 processor. And you need 58 gigs of space.
Whoa!
On top of what it already takes up.
The game is already like 60 gigs.
Yep.
Jesus Christ, you need a dedicated hard drive just for Fallout now.
Mm-hmm. That would kill my little SSD I have running my computer. That is insane.
Oh, yeah, that's ridiculous.
Did you guys also see that Fallout Shelter is now available on the Xbox One and PS4?
Meh. I played it on the tablet. It was fun for about half an hour.
Actually, is it coming to PS4? I thought they said it wasn't.
I believe it's out. I don't know if it's... I know it's definitely on the Xbox.
Yeah, I saw it on definitely coming out for the Xbox also, but I don't know about the PlayStation yet.
We're going to look that up right now. To the internet.
Yeah, it's not like answers. It's not like none of us are on computers or anything.
Yeah.
Okay, there's no actual answer for PS4 at the moment. So it's only on the Xbox One at the moment.
Yes, it may not come to the PS4.
What?
Oh, the humanity.
No. But guess what? It's probably going to be on your PC anyways.
It's on PC.
It's on PC, yeah. Because they made it for like that crossplay thing. So they made it for PC.
Oh, yes. So Windows 10
on the Xbox.
Yeah.
It was available for PC before it was available for Xbox, though.
Yes, it was.
Yeah, like long before. And yeah, because it came out for iOS first, then it dropped for Android, then it got a PC release, and then like a year later, it got the Xbox release.
I played it for a little while. I admit I spent a few bucks on it, but then I don't know, it just stopped being interesting.
Yeah,
I just got annoyed with it because like I had like so much, like I needed like so much in resources. Mm-hmm. But I don't, it's like I have too many people in my shelter. So I need to have, like, a ton of resource collection going. But I don't have enough people to man all of the resources that I need to collect in order to actually keep everyone alive and happy. It's like this weird catch-22 thing. I have, like, three power plants, two water systems, three diners or cafeterias or whatever. So it's like I should be collecting enough stuff, but my energy depletes way too quickly, so I lose rooms. So that means I don't get enough. So that, and usually the first ones to go are like the water and the cafeteria. So I'm now losing water production and food production, which is now slowing everything else down, which is slowing down energy production, which is the shutting off more systems. And it's like, I just got annoyed and that's why I stopped playing.
And there were cockroaches involved.
Yeah, that too. They kept killing people.
I know, they're really jerks. They're jerks, man.
They really are.
I could never get the app to work properly. It would always just, it would always delete my actual vault. I kind of just start again every time I load it up, and it's just like, kind of just thinking it's not really worth it if I just play the tutorial and then stopping, and then it's not saving.
Truthfully, Jamie, if you've played any kind of like park builder or city builder app, yeah, it's basically that.
Mm-hmm. I mean, it was very popular when it first came out, though, which is kind of shocking, really. When
yeah. Just,
okay. So is Pokemon.
I mean, they saw the word Fallout and they're like, we're in.
Sure.
Yeah. Although I will admit, I've put more money in Pokemon than I have Fallout Shelter, so.
Speaking of Pokemon, Pokemon Go have just announced their Valentine's Day event.
Really?
Yep.
What was
all
it?
All pink Pokemon are now more common.
Oh.
Time to get your Jigglypuff.
Oh my.
I think it's that, and they've like doubled candy and walking distance and stuff like that. As they normally
do. Oh, goody. Because doubling the candy is actually like really good.
Doubling the candy, yeah. Level up your harder Pokemon quicker.
Mm-hmm. Oh, and for anyone who is still playing Pokemon Go as well, if I've actually found out that through a friend that if you have Togepi, or we're able to hatch a Togepi, you can actually evolve it, I believe, all the way up to Togekiss. Which was never part of Gen 2. That was like Gen 4 or 5, I think.
That was way up there, yeah.
Yeah, you're able to get it to Togetic, but they're actually, if you look at like the Pokédex, once you hatch it, you can actually see the other evolutions on it. So you can, by theory, you should be able to actually level it up to Togekiss.
That's interesting. I mean, I think they've already put that in before.
Mm.
Probably doing Gen 2. I'm surprised, honestly, when they did that update to add some of Gen 2, I'm surprised they didn't just add all the evolutions of Gen 1 Pokemon to Gen 2 Pokemon. Like Steelix and Crobat and stuff. That should have just been in.
Yeah.
Way too much of a company.
Yeah. And remember this. Remember, this is Niantic. This isn't Nintendo. You know.
Yeah.
I do sometimes feel they take it a little bit too long to move along with the game a bit. But then I realize that I'm missing still missing 40 Gen 1 Pokemon. So. I mean, they haven't even done anything with the legendaries yet. It's been quite a while.
Well, speaking of slow stuff, Final Fantasy VII, huh? Yeah, that's never going to happen.
It's coming.
It's getting there, man. Eventually. You know, they're doing it episode per chapter per scene. Slowly.
Yeah. It will happen one day, eventually, possibly.
I still think you have a better chance of getting Final Fantasy VII than, Half-Life 3, though. To be honest.
It's true. But then again, they teased Half-Life 3 for a while before it just became like a running joke. So, I mean, this could be the start of Final Fantasy 7 could become the new Half-Life 3. You get either that or it'll be Final Fantasy 7-3 will be the new meme. You get the first two parts of it and then the third one just never comes out.
What's the last game that Valve made?
Portal 2. It was either Portal 2 or Dota 2.
Dota 2 would have been the last one, I think, that came out, because Dota came out roughly when Steam got really big.
Is that all they've been doing is working on Steam and their console thing?
And the Source 2 engine.
Yeah, the Source 2 engine. And then they're also, like, because of the Steam Greenlight project, they're helping a lot of indie developers.
Yeah, that's true. A lot of stuff gets greenlit. Some stuff shouldn't even be a game, but there's some good things mixed in there.
Oh, yeah.
Honestly, that's my problem with indie content, is it just lets some people who shouldn't be allowed to make games make games. It's the same with movies, honestly. There's so many like indie movies where you can just watch and you can just tell they didn't put the right kind of effort into this.
Mm-hmm.
And like they don't deserve it in a way. I have the same approach with YouTube now. YouTube is just so big and so like accessible to a lot of people. You end up seeing channels of just like people like eating their dinner or something and just thinking,
yep.
It's just like, why are you a thing? Why do you deserve to be a thing on a platform where people watch you?
Because it's free.
And then why do you end up at the end of the video had a link to a Patreon where people pay you to continue making the content that people seem to want?
It's it's pretty amazing what people donate their money to. But hey, if you like it, then that's what happens, I suppose.
I like how you use the word donate, because some people just will buy stuff that they know is not actually not a thing.
That's true. But, that is true.
Because you gotta love the guys buying Cards Against Humanity.
Also true. Yeah, I got a copy of Exploding Kittens, so.
I mean, every holiday. Alright, this is a box of bullcrap. They're all bullcrap. We're not joking. People will buy it anyways, thinking it's a joke, and you just get a box of dried bullcrap.
And then they get all pissed off.
Mm-hmm. And they say people have too much money.
See that?
Exactly, yeah.
Damn it.
But this year will be different. This year they'll send us actually something proper. Oh, this stinks.
Yeah. So actually, it took too long, which I'm surprised. Actually, I'm sorry. You know, it took longer than I thought it would.
What?
So if you're under 18, earmuffs. There's a Metal Gear Solid porn parody that has finally been released.
Did they just do it in the
Yes.
It's just in the socket.
Yep. They made the Overwatch one actually first. And now they made a Metal Gear one called the Phantom Peen.
Ah, yes. Surely there's a better one than that.
Well, I mean there might be, but this is the official, parody. Mm-hmm.
Or you could do something Metal Gear Solid. Probably something like that.
See, it has the word in it.
Oh, Snake, you're so solid.
Wow. See that? I was waiting for Trevor to make that joke.
I'm imagining like a guard guy getting an erection and there's just that noise. Like,
Never gonna play Metal Gear the same now.
Snake gets in a box and there's just a hole. And the guard just starts walking towards it.
Well, you actually gotta say that you're gonna be rather silent playing, maybe quiet even.
Ow. That's just. Yeah. Yeah, so you gotta. Well, yeah.
Did you just say there's an Overwatch 1 too?
There is an Overwatch 1.
Did they just go with the humanoid characters, or did they go all out and get a gorilla?
Do you really want
to know that answer?
I'm honestly not sure. I know definitely D.Va's in there and Reaper. So.
The idea of Reaper just being full in his full costume, but he's cocks out. He's just like, he's in a circle of women, he's just spinning around so they're all getting a bit. cock slapping them all.
So this has actually been Jamie's platform, because apparently this is his side job. He directs and choreographs.
I could do comedic porn. Reinhardt, hammer down.
Well, I mean, that joke does write itself, let's be honest.
It does.
It
does.
It doesn't make it any less funny.
It does.
I said it did, but yeah.
They find out Bastion has a second alt mode.
Hey, look at that. E3 is going to be open to the public.
Yeah.
The only thing happens to the public.
Are this time?
Are they going to have a screening of the Solid
Snake? It's going to be $150.
Currently, before it goes up to $230.
$250.
Oh, God. Yeah. Yeah, that's right. $250.
Where is E3 this year?
LA.
I mean, it's always in LA. Or no. Is it ever in Las Vegas?
No,
I think it used to be in Las Vegas. And then
they tried to move it there from Los Angeles, but I don't think it ever went through.
I thought it went 1 year, and only 1 year.
I think it did. I think it went the year before they decided it needed to be tamer.
Yeah.
I think that was the year that it was, I guess, it turned into some giant, you know, rave party.
They started showcasing the after-hour movies too soon.
Directed by Jamie.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Oh,
it's what? The Overwatch porn parody is called Oversnatch.
And this
wait
is what
a minute. Are you allowed to look that up in England?
It's a private browser.
Oh, all right.
That doesn't matter.
Oh. Reaper's ultimate is called Dick Blossom.
And there's the show, folks.
Oh, that's a thing.
That's a thing.
The internet's great.
That's what it's here for.
It's just a Widowmaker and Reaper.
Oh, it's Widowmaker.
Yeah.
Yep. Now
I
James.
Do more of that cast.
Now he's disappointed.
I mean, it's the internet. You gotta get a gorilla.
Now he's gonna have to write the British version.
Just start in Tracer.
I was gonna say have to do in Tracer.
So it keeps you the ability to just keep recharging. It never stops.
Oh, man. It's funny. It's funny because it's true.
It's funny because it exists.
That's right.
It's funny because some person showed up to set, got given a Reaper mask, and just went to town.
That's exactly true. Oh, man. There's just no coming back from after that conversation.
Oh, no.
Wow. No, actually, Trevor, I wanted to ask you: do you do the Humble monthly bundle thing?
I do every now and again. I haven't in a while though.
Oh, you know what this month is?
Isn't this month the? Is this the one the Star Wars one? Or is this the?
This is Total War.
Total War one. Oh.
Total War Warhammer for $12.
Oh, I'm only missing DLC for that though. That's the thing.
Oh, you already have it.
Yep. That's right.
Forgot. Yep. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I would love to be able to play it, but I haven't been able to recently.
Did you break our computer like Dave?
No, the last update broke the game for my computer.
Oh, perfect. Even better.
Yes.
Don't you love that?
Yeah.
That's the downside of the PC. Although, no, console updates do break things, but normally not as bad.
Oh yeah, not that bad generally.
Sometimes phone's ringing. Is anyone getting Halo Wars 2?
I might. I'm likely to.
I'm more than likely going to pass.
I guess I'm the only one getting the deluxe edition. All right, guys.
I loved the first one.
Yeah, I was watching gameplay of it. It seems pretty... I mean, the controls seem more refined than the first one. At least playing on, you know, a computer. So...
They seem to be still embracing that whole... I don't know what the best word for it is. It's when you, like... It's when you have something in the game where you have to pay for and buy and that kind of thing. Like, microtransaction.
Because
they got, like, a game type where you build your army based on cards you collect through packs and stuff. So it's that kind of thing. It's the exact same thing, I mean, it's exactly what Halo 5 had. Like, the whole system of unlocking stuff was through that card-based thing. Mm. Like, some people weren't a fan of it. Because, like, there was no, like, choice or decision to it. It's just... Just you buy something and just see what the game decides you get.
Well,
it interests me. I'll check it out. I'm honestly, in a way, I'm really looking forward to the campaign. Just because I do kind of, I really like the characters from the first Halo Wars.
So where does Halo Wars fit in the Halo timeline?
The first one or the second one? Which one do you want?
Yes.
First Halo Wars is before the majority of the Halo games.
The first Halo Wars is before all of the Halo games.
Including Reach?
Yep, before Reach.
Okay.
Okay, yeah. So it goes Halo Wars 1 and then Reach?
Yes. And then the rest of the Halo games.
In order?
And then it's the rest of the... Well, kind of. Halo. Then it's Halo 1, Halo 2... First Halo two missions of Halo 2, ODST, rest of Halo 2, 3, 4, 5. And then Halo Wars 2 is in the 4, 5 range.
Oh, so it's in between those, or does it happen like at the same time?
The way it works, I think, is like Halo Wars happens, and it's for a whole different time. Like there's like Spartans everywhere, that kind of thing. And then I think in the end of it, they go into, like, hyperspace, so everyone goes to sleep.
Mm-hmm.
And now they're waking up in a world where everything's happened. Like, Master Chief's taking down the Covenant, all that kind of stuff's happened without them knowing it. So now they're just coming out in a whole, basically a brand new kind of world.
So Halo Wars 2 is 28 years after the first one.
After the first Halo Wars.
Yes. Yeah. The first one took place in 2531, which is before the original Halo games.
Hmm.
Yeah, the new one takes place in 2559.
Yes.
Interesting.
I also like, think they're doing with this game is the main villain is a brute. But it's
really?
Like a very, he's an intelligent, strategic, like general kind of brute.
Huh.
Which is probably the second time we're getting a character like that. The first one being the brute from Halo 2. I'm kind of looking forward to that. His whole backstory is that he's part of a Covenant faction called the Banished, which are like just kind of like Covenant that refuse to say no.
Because the only other thing would be is resetting the rally, and that would kick me offline.
And continue to follow the Brute's leadership instead of that whole civil war that went on between the Covenant.
Okay. Oh, I got it finally. So Halo Wars 2 takes place 1 year after Halo 5 Guardians.
So it
jumps from before all the games to after the current games.
Huh.
I wonder if it means that the Halo Wars characters will tie in with Halo 6 at all.
Possible.
Maybe. So wait. So is Master Chief around for Halo Wars 2?
No.
No. But, like, I think it takes place on, like a planet, like a deserted planet kind of thing.
Halo Wars 2 takes place in a place we've all been before, actually.
Where?
The Ark.
Wait,
oh,
what?
Yeah.
Yeah, it takes place on the Ark.
Didn't the Ark explode?
There's more than one Ark.
Oh, damn it. How convenient.
The Forerunners were better than Noah. They built more than one.
Bastards. Convenient buying more arcs.
What I like about this as well is, like, the entire Visual Chief story is, like, he's the last boss in all this. And now Halo Wars 5, Halo 5 brought, like, the rest of Blue Team, they're still alive. And now in Halo Wars 2, like, three more Spartans are just going to show up, the ones that were asleep on the ship the whole time. Like, Chief went through a lot of stuff thinking he was the last Spartan, and then suddenly, like six more.
Yeah, it's like, oh, hey, his teams are alive. Oh, hi, everyone. Where did these come from?
Every Spartan in the world shows up. She's like, oh, I'm not alone. Hey.
And just to think, what would have happened, or how gaming would be if Microsoft didn't buy Bungie?
Or if they ended Halo at...
Because initially, Bungie only did Mac games. That was it. And then, I think the rumor was Steve Jobs actually wanted to buy Bungie, because they were, like, the biggest game maker for Mac. And then right before that happened, Microsoft bought them. And now we have the Halo that we know now, and Destiny.
Mm-hmm.
Which, if you go back and look at YouTube, actually just download the game called Marathon, you can see all the characters, not all of them, but the main alien villains, or alien things that you're shooting at in Marathon, are the Fallen in Destiny. Literally. Forearms, goofy looking heads. It's like the exact same model.
That's cool.
So it's cool they kept some of their little history going. Oh, and Trevor, the Star Wars monthly bundle is now.
Oh, okay. What's that one?
The thing you do monthly is the Total War one.
Okay, so I knew I saw it somewhere. I got that email.
Yeah, so if you pay $35, you get a Star Wars T-shirt.
Oh boy!
along with every Star Wars game ever, which is probably they're probably too old to actually play on your computer and won't run. Right.
I'm just talking about. I managed to get all of the Jedi Knight games working on my computer.
Oh really?
Yes.
How much did you have to downgrade it, though?
I got it to the best settings that they got possible, so I think the resolution went down from 1920 to something probably like closer to 800 or 1200.
Really?
Yeah. You remember exactly what was high end back when those came out.
This is true. That's very true. So I think that's a podcast, unless you guys have anything to add to it.
I just got a question for you, though.
Yes, sir.
When are you planning on getting Civ 6?
One more turn. 7 p.m., one more turn. Oh, look, it's 3 a.m., one more turn.
Oh, no, Gandhi nuked you.
It's kind of funny that that became a running joke. Yeah. Actually, how much is Civ 6 going for now?
Full price still.
Jerks.
Just keep waiting.
It's been out for a while, though, hasn't it?
Yeah, a year.
October of last year. Plus, it also currently has two DLC, adding Civs, so it's up to 10. So if you want everything, you gotta add another $10.
And but there's even a 25th anniversary one. Wait, I'm sorry, what did you say about mods?
They're getting workshop support in the next update.
No kidding. Interesting. Oh, poor Beyond Earth is like on clearance for a hard copy of it.
Oh,
did you play that?
Sadly,
it was that good, huh?
it was repetitive in a DLC, more or less. A $40 DLC.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Out of curiosity, did anyone ever put in any money into WoW Star Citizen?
I did not.
I never played it.
Did not either.
Yeah, I don't know why it just popped into my head, but I'm like thinking to myself, no one's heard anything about that lately, and as far as I know, the game still hasn't been released yet, even with, like, you know, the $900 million it's raised. So.
Yeah, that's the, actually, there's been a couple of Kickstarters that, like, made their, goal, like, pretty quick. Mutant League Football, that made its goal, like, within, actually, did it make its goal? It's close, I think. But,
Super Troopers 2.
Yep. Pillars of Eternity made their goal, like, or no, not Pillars of Eternity. What is the name of that game? Damn it, now I gotta look it up.
Yeah, because I remember they hit the goal pretty quick, and then it was just, they kept adding all these stretch goals and, like, adding more stuff to it, and more stuff to it, and more stuff to it. And I think, like, once they finally hit, like, the $160 million mark, it was just like, okay, we really can't think of anything else to add in. Mm-hmm. But they kept still getting money and donations for it. And I still don't think the game, I mean, they've talked about, like, releasing alphas for it, but I don't know if it ever came out because, like, people just stopped talking about it. But it was, like, one of the biggest, like, video game Kickstarters of all time. So.
Oh, I was thinking of Divinity Original Sin. They're making a sequel to that, and that got its Kickstarter goal, like, in 2 days. Which is pretty crazy to think about.
Well, Shenmue 3 also made it in, like, 2 or 3 days, but then people got really pissed off when they found out, you know, they're sinking $2 million into a game, and it was, like, totally backed by Sony to begin with.
Yep.
That's such a dumb thing, like, the whole Sony, like, back the game, or we'll have to pay for it ourselves. So that's why I very rarely actually trust a Kickstarter now, just because if it's not going to be made, the person's just going to take the money, or...
Yeah.
Or it's just one of those examples where, like, they were funded basically anyway, but they just decided to see if people would pay them to play the game.
Yeah.
Pay them to make the game so they can play it. The whole Shenmue 3 thing was just ridiculous.
Mm. The which thing?
Shenmue 3.
Oh. Like, yeah.
If you're gonna make a game, make a game. If you're not. But don't, like, pretend you're not going to make a game when you know full well you are.
I think a lot of companies, not companies, but yeah, probably companies, they do Kickstarters just to get, like, an idea if people would be interested in the game before they actually try to officially make it, you know?
Yeah.
They kind of use it as a gauge, so... So yeah, so I think that was an official podcast.
Is there an official seal on it?
We will put an official seal on that. Jamie, thank you for staying awake with us.
Thank you for being you.
Oh, thanks. Trevor, thank you for waking up.
I was awake.
James, thank you for joining us again, sir.
Always.
And Randall might be cooking right now, so I don't know if he hears me, but Randall, thank you for being the man behind the curtain.
I hear all.
See that? He's there. He knows.
He's going to dinner, Randall.
And that wasn't even an edit.
Whatever Randall just said.
whatever he just said. That's right.
That's our Randall.
But thank you for tuning in with us this week. Remember, you can find everything Team D.B.A.H. at teamdbah.blogspot.com, where every week you get links to the podcast, you get Jamie's wonderful reviews of his loot crates. You also get Jake's comic book pull list. So if you want to know what to read every week, because there's, let's face it, there's a lot of comics that come out all the time. It's very hard to keep track of. He puts it all on a nice little list there, what you should be reading. Also, don't forget to check out our videos on YouTube. You get a new video practically every day. Every day, there is something new from Team D.B.A.H., so make sure you subscribe to that. And we still have the little banner on top of our site, so if you'd like a free two free audiobooks, you just click on that link for Audible, and you can get two free audiobooks of your choice. So even if you don't sign up, you get to keep the books you pick. So that's pretty cool, too. Also, it would be really cool if you like this podcast, and this actually goes for any podcast you like, if you go to iTunes, leave them a review with some stars, hopefully 5 stars. It really helps the podcast get noticed on iTunes and, you know, gets our name out there for everyone to hear and enjoy. This has been the official Team D.B.A.H. podcast, number 178. Remember, folks, don't be a hero. Good night.